straight to the deepest secrets of different bills. Hey, don't the demon, you need it, I got it listed here. You wanna make it, I'll show you just how to make it here. I got all the rarest bills, and I ain't done yet. Move from defenders to making bills like a prospect. Flow space and slashes to catching us with a law threat. You keep the medals, cause the realm is coming up next. Only scratch the surface, still they try to drag my name in dirt, they try to bring me down. See me winning, you ain't like me.
Yo, what's good, my nephews and nieces? This is your favorite uncle, Uncle Demi. And today, I have another special banger for you. All right, now listen. Before we get too far in the video, you know exactly what you need to do. Make sure you drop a like. And let's get this video to at least 1,000 likes. That would definitely push the video to the recommended. And furthermore, if you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe. I'm by far the hardest working YouTuber in the 2K community. And hopefully you can appreciate that 9 a.m. and that 5 p.m. daily double uploads. And you can show that appreciation by dropping a like and subscribing, all right? Now, let's get straight into this video. So today, my nephews and nieces, we have another extremely rare build, a two-way slashing four. And once again, we have to shout out one of the nephews and nieces. And this day, it is going to be another nephew, and actually his second time popping up on the channel. And that's going to be Andrew the Goat 23. Shout out to Andrew the Goat 23. He also is the one that gave us the two-way balance score, and now he has found the two-way slashing four. So shout out to Andrew the Goat. I tell you over and over again, if you want to be on the channel, just make sure you hit me up on Discord. Most of the time on Discord is where I really get all the info, but you can still try to hit me up on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. But if you haven't joined my Discord, check my Discord. The link is in the description. That is where I really be able to give you my feedback on the builds that you give me, okay? But anyway, let's hop right into the video. So what we're going to do is go power forward. We want to go left or right-handed, doesn't matter. I'm left-handed IRL, so I go left-handed. You want to go with the mostly defensive pie chart with the little bit of finishing. So that's the one that we're going to rock with. And then you want to go pure speed. You have to go pure speed to get the name, which is really crazy this year. And because in 2K20, it was like this. Not in 21 as much, but in 2K20, pie physical profile actually had a lot to do with the name. So there could be times where you're making an extremely rare build, like a two-way slashing four, but you're going speed invert or you're going balance. And, you know, you just got to find the right physical pie chart and attribute. So it's really hard this year. But, hey, Andrew found it, man. So we want to go pure speed. Then I'm gonna give you two ways to make this, okay? So this is gonna be the first way. The first way is gonna give you shooting, all right? So if you wanna have some shooting in the pie chart, this is the route you wanna go, all right? Max out your mid-range. You wanna go 76 on the free throw in that post phase, so you'll get six right there. Then you wanna max out your pass accuracy, your ball handling, your post control, your interior defense, your perimeter defense, your lateral quickness, your block, and then your defensive rebound, right? So what you're looking at is 7, 6, 13, and 19, okay? Now, this is a really, really well-balanced type build, right? So it gives you an opportunity, but they're shooting the mid-range. You do have a post fade. You have some post control, defense, and of course, you're going to have really good finishing at the basket, right? But let's say, for instance, you're somebody that wants to have, don't care about the shooting, and then you want to have more defense and more standing dunk and finishing. So then, of course, you can take away all this. And if you take away all this, then, of course, you can max out your driving dunk for your standing dunk for 22. Then of course you max out your offensive rebound for 24. And then, okay, so that four there. So let's see where that four goes. All right, so the four doesn't even really matter. So that four would just pull in the steal, all right? So now you're looking at 22, 1, 13, 24. So you could go either or. It's really your call. It's really your preference. Me, I already have a build that does that cannot shoot. So, and that's gonna be my defensive anchor build. So I rather have a build that can shoot. So I just think that in this instance, I'm gonna go ahead and go this route. But again, like I said, you can go any route that you want, whatever you feel comfortable with. I just wanted to show y'all two different versions so you can be able to make that decision yourself. And you know, hey, it is what it is. It's whatever you're happy with. So obviously I take a hit on the standing dunk and finishing. I take a hit on my offensive rebound and my defensive, but I do get six shooting badges, so I'm able to shoot in the mid-range, and I have a post fade, okay? But it's really your call, okay? You can't, you know, shooting, no shooting, you can still be a really good pick-and-roller build, get into the basket, that type of deal, all right? Body type, you want to go compact because you're about to add on a lot of weight, all right? So you want to go compact. Then you want to drop all the way down to 6'7", okay? Then you want to get your weight all the way to 275, all right? 275. Then your wingspan, you only want to go up to 86. Do not go past 86. If you go past 86, you will be called interior finisher, all right? So you want to stay right here. okay? So now let's talk about a few things. You do get a plus 8 to your physicals, and you get that plus 8 to your physicals by doing either of these three things, all right? For one, from 95 to 99, you get plus 4 there, right? So that's that first half of the plus 4. To get the second half of the plus 4, you have to do these three things. Either A, go into my career, you have to play until you become a starter. Then once you become a starter, to sim out the rest of the season, then you have to actually play every playoff game, win a championship, and you get the gym rat badge, okay? Or B, head to the park, go in the Gatorade facility, talk to the guy in the entrance. He'll give you a quest of just hitting gym rat by hitting level 40 in your season pass, and you'll be able to get that. And then C, what you have to do is just what a lot of people do. Every 7 days, go to the Gatorade facility, get a plus 4 in the workout, and of course, you get your plus 4, all right? So what you're looking at is an 89 speed, an 88 acceleration, and an 89 vert, and an 83 strength. So extremely balanced, all right? There's a lot of good things coming out of here, especially with the strength, the vert, the acceleration, the speed, especially to be 6'7", 275 pounds. So that's really good. And then on your finishing, shooting, playmaking, defensive rebound, you also get a plus 4. So what really stands out here is you have that 94 driving dunk. So you'll be able to get all the different type of contact dunks that they had to offer, a 68 mid-range, which is gonna allow you to shoot really well in the mid-range. You also have a 73 post fade, which is also gonna be good because if you always come into the post, you can be able to work there. You have a 77 pass accuracy and a 75 ball handle. So yes, you will be able to speed and momentum dribble with this build. So keep that in mind. You will be able to momentum dribble with this build. You have a 75 post control, and then defense is just really crazy. So your defense, check this out, an 81 interior defense, an 89 perimeter, an 87 lateral quickness, 77 block, and an 82 defensive rebound. So basically everything that you need, you will have, right? Which is pretty dope, okay? Now again, this build can be a pick and popper, and it can be a spot up, but you have to spot up in the mid-range, okay? So just keep that in mind, right? So the spacing on your side won't be as much, but all you really have to do is just have your feet on the line or in front of the line, and that'll be considered a mid-range shot, okay? And then, of course, you got to go slashing here. And the reason why I say slashing, because this will allow you to have that 75 ball handle become an 85, and then that 89 speed will become a 99 speed. So you will be able to momentum dribble on that type of deal. And to me, it just makes more sense. So this is why I say go here. And then here you have it, my nephews and nieces. For the first time, we have a two-way slashing 4. So shout out to my man Andrew for that. And then what we're going to do here is just give them the 99, we'll go over the badges, and then we'll get you out of here, okay? So let's do that. So the ones that's gonna be most important here is gonna be posterizer, it's gonna be fearless finisher. Of course, you wanna have fast twitch, and then you also wanna have slithery finisher. You definitely wanna have acrobat if you're gonna be playing around with that. Rise up is a good one, but you don't have a high standing dunk, so that's why I'm not really worried about that. Limitless takeoff is good. And then again, you could also, if you wanna have some fun with it, back down punisher, post spin technician are some really good ones to have too, just because you are able to be able to go into the post. And then here, what the big ones here is going to be hot zone hunter and then catch and shoot, okay? So hot zone hunter and catch and shoot is going to be really, really good for you. I mean, that's all I have on my lockdown build with a 54 three ball, and I'm actually able to shoot consistently, so that's the only ones that I would want. And then on the playmaking side, it's really here, so you want to go quick first step, of course, and triple threat juke. Those are going to be the two big ones that are really going to allow you to do the things that you're trying to do. So you want to go there. Unpluckable. Also, you want to go ahead and get unpluckable on silver at least. You can probably go a little bit higher. Post playmaker is going to be a good one for the pass out of the post. I like the bailout part, and I also want bullet passer. But if you don't want the post playmaker, then you can go ahead and just upgrade these right here. Or something like that, and be perfectly fine too. But quick first step and triple threat juke are the big ones that you're going to want to be looking at for being able to get past your defenders. And then here again, brick wall is if you're going to be setting screens. If you're not, then you don't need it. But we go brick wall, we'll go rebound chaser, we'll go rim protector. Of course, you want intimidator, you want chase down for the animations. And then for that last two, you can go interceptor. Or you can kind of go just clamps on silver and don't worry about the interceptor part. And if you're not, and you're just going to be sitting on the corner, spotting up as a catch and shoot, then obviously have some more left over. I would probably go Hustler, to be honest with you. That might be the best bet to have. But it's really your call. But there you have it, my nephews and nieces. This is the two-way slashing four. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, you know what you need to do. Just make sure you drop a like, subscribe to the channel, and as usual, your favorite old head, Uncle Demi. I'll be back really, really soon on the banger, man. And you know, when I say I'll be back soon on the banger, you know exactly what I'm talking about. I'm talking about tomorrow, man. I'm out.